Hello, everyone. This is Tom Fox, and I'd like to welcome you to the Daily Compliance News. The Daily Compliance News is an offering of the Compliance Podcast Network. May 6, 2019, the Diamonds Are Forever issue. First up, from the Washington Post, the company Britax Child Safety sent defective replacement parts for its jogging stroller to nearly 200 customers after they discovered that the strollers were unsafe and were poised for spontaneous failure. The interesting thing was that the agency, or rather the company, was not apparently interested in fixing the problem because the parts they sent out for to fix the problem were in fact defective. Also, the consumer regulatory body allowed this to happen, and it backed off its demands for a total recall, which is clearly the direction the Trump administration is going in, making consumers pay for defective products, not the people who made them. Next up, why does compliance need a seat at the table? Well, the Wall Street Journal reports that tech giants are rethinking the businesses that made them big. Facebook, Apple, Amazon, and Google are seeking out new places to disrupt. Moving into a new business area presents new risks. And the question I would pose to each one of these companies is, does compliance have a seat at the table so that they can help evaluate the compliance risks for the new business areas? Next up, turns out the news just gets worse and worse for Boeing. As it turns out, they knew about the safety alert problem for a year before telling the FAA. They didn't share the problem with the FAA about the cockpit safety alert, which drew the attention after the October 737 MAX crash in India. And in fact, it was only after the second crash in January that the Boeing became more forthcoming with airlines about the problem. So, you know, it just gets worse and worse for Boeing, and they really appear to be headed down a very, very bad path, both in terms of reputational risk, potential legal liability, and regulatory scrutiny going forward. And finally, if you wondered whether or not diamonds are forever, well, it turns out they are. As in a report by Reuters, diamonds jewelry linked to the Malaysian sovereign wealth fund 1MDB scandal are handed over to the U.S. A $1.7 million jewelry set allegedly bought by the mother of the fugitive Malaysian financier, Jay Lowe, was handed over to the U.S. government. Lowe has been charged in Malaysia and United States, but is still on the run. So turns out these diamonds are forever, and they're part of the agreement to help refund monies of those who had losses in the United States. Of course, Goldman Sachs is still on the hook with the Malaysian government, and there's been no resolution of that. And indeed, the U.S. prosecutors are pushing for a guilty plea from Goldman Sachs for their role in the 1MDB scandal. But it wasn't simply Goldman Sachs. It was everyone who helped them, Jay Lowe and his cronies, steal the money and then spend the money. So diamonds are forever. You didn't check the latest episode out, Popcorn and Compliance, please do so, because Jay and I are joined by Sean Friedland to break down the Avengers movie Endgame. Sean is an MC Universe aficionado. We recently premiered two new shows on the Compliance Podcast Network in Modern Medium. Paris Fox takes a look at how you go through the process of designing art and why it's so important for the compliance practitioner to utilize these skills in their communications with their employees. In Forensically Speaking, Jonathan Marks helps you understand the forensic side of compliance.